Hi friends, today we'll discuss about financial inclusion. What is financial inclusion? Financial services and facilities to the weaker sections of society. Like, what are the financial services? It can be a savings bank account, or it may be a small loan, or it may be a deposit. Any financial service to the weaker sections of the society. So, what is the main aim for the financial inclusion is like including weaker section people into the banking services or financial services. Loan to the rural people without obtaining collateral for income generating purpose in order to reduce the poverty levels. So giving loans to the rural people without obtaining collateral. For example, you want a housing loan, then you have to give a house as a collateral. If you want a vehicle loan, your vehicle will be a collateral. You want a loan against deposit, deposit will be collateral. You want a business loan, then your stock will be your collateral. But in these loans, there won't be any collateral. And this, whatever amount you are giving to the weaker section, they should get an income generation. With investing this small amount, they can open a small business. Then they start generating income. So this is called financial inclusion. So whom they can take these loans? These loans can be taken by self-help groups, joint liability groups. So in India, loans will be given to joint liability groups only. So you can give it to self-help groups also, but major part will be joint liability. So joint liability means, individual liability means, if I take a loan, I am liable to pay. But if it is a loan given to joint liability group, one person is not paying, other people has to share and loan should be repaid. So this is the joint liability group. So this group consists of individuals. 4-5 members will become a group. It can be self-help group or joint liability group. Self-help group or joint liability group comprises only women members only. So in these groups, women members will be there and loan will be given to these people only. So what is the minimum size should be available in this self-help group or joint liability group? Minimum will be 5 members and maximum will be 20 members. So one member from a family means, for example, one group is there. In that group, one family member can contribute one member only. You can't take 2 members from one family. So anyone to be member of only one, if I am an individual, I can be a member of one self-help group or joint liability group. I can't be member in 2 groups. Okay, and one more, in one group only one family member is allowed. So what is the meeting point? These self-help groups or joint liability groups, they have to meet fixed day in a month, fixed time and fixed place for all the meetings, and you have to record all the meetings and accounts, activities, whatever we are doing the on the day of meeting, everything should be recorded. And this meeting will be, for example, second Friday, a third Friday, morning 10 o'clock. There should not be any change. It should be fixed. So loan amount under self-help groups or joint liability groups, minimum will be 15,000 and maximum will be 50,000 rupees. And rural micro enterprise loan will be 1.25 lakhs. No collateral means, when you are giving a loan, no collateral. It should be on basis of the group only. So for these self-help groups or joint liability groups, bank can give a no frill accounts. These accounts can be used for the basic banking, like your cash deposit, cash withdrawal, fund transfer, and these accounts will be given to the low income group. Minimum charges, in some cases there won't be any charges for these accounts. So loans provided by banks, staff, state government, microfinance institutions. So these loans can be provided by bank, state government or microfinance institutions. Interest rate is lower than money lenders rate. Money lenders interest rate will be more, like they'll charge them 30%, 40%, 50% per annum, and lot of conditions will be there. But all the microfinance loans will be interest rate will be less than the money lenders interest rate. Lending to the microfinance is called private sector lending only. So whatever the organization they are lending for the self-help groups or joint liability groups, 90% of their assets are qualifying assets. There should not be any non-performing assets, no NPAs. So 90% should be a qualified assets. And whatever the loan you are giving, the borrower, the self-help group member, borrower should not exceed his income more than 50,000. So his income should be less than 50,000 per annum. And maximum loan already we have discussed, 1.25 lakhs. So few more points we can discuss under these microfinance loans. Maximum of 2 microfinance companies to lend a single borrower. Means one single borrower can take loan from 2 microfinance institutions. Means I am a single borrower, I can take from one microfinance institute and second microfinance institute. And while taking the loan, there will be processing fees and interest and insurance charges. And a maximum interest rate should be charged on the microfinance loans is 33% only, including all your penal, overdue interest, everything. It should not cross 33%. This video prepared with the blessings of Sri Nrisimha Bharati Swami, Peetadhipati, Sri Pushpagiri, Sarada Lakshmi Narasimha Swami Peetam. Thank you, friends. If you like my video, please subscribe and share with your friends also.